Matt Piscitella of NPD calls the August 2019 NPD results weird, with a lot of things happening. What the hell is making him say that? Let's get into it. What's up, peoples? It is your boy MM2K back again with another one. Do me a huge favor, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when your boy's dropping these doses. I appreciate all of y'all straight up because y'all know the deal, baby. I am not too proud to ask. Let's get into it. Okay, so August 2019 NPD results have been released. And for those of you that live under a rock, NPD is a monthly reporting that comes out in various stuff, and we're going to focus on the NPD reportings for video games, okay? So before we get too deep into this one, I want to chop it up. You know how I do it. I first want to do the checkup, you know what I'm saying, an explanation of the NPDs. I want to do the analysis of the current results that were released, and then I want to give you my thoughts to wrap it all up. First, the checkup. Now, again, NPD is the monthly reporting on the video game industry in the United States, okay? It measures rankings of top purchases by dollars made off of unit sales, not just pure units. It's highly important because it is a very good measurement of success in regards to video games, because the United States is the number one console gaming market in the world, all right? So even though we got entities like Microsoft that don't want to release numbers, you know what I mean, and this generation, and we had PlayStation do something similar to last generation at certain points of time, we can always rely on NPD to get a very good litmus of where these companies are doing, whether they want to be forthgoing with their numbers or not. With that said, here's the analysis. Here's the raw data from the NPD that was released that was relevant, and we're going to get into some of the stuff that Matt Piscitella said was quote-unquote weird. Okay, so first and foremost, year over year, software, hardware, and accessories and game cards were down 18% in pure dollars. Now, when I say year over year, from August 2018 to now August 2019, when you compare the two time frames, it's down 18%. Everything is down. And this is the lowest August in spending since 1998. Now, people may speculate why. I'm not even 100% sure why. And Matt Piscitella himself, because it's been so low this month, and it hasn't been this low since 1998. That definitely indeed is one of the weird things. Just one, though, of the NPD this month. All right, so let's talk about year-to-date numbers for 2019. Total dollars are down 6%. Software is marginally up, though, all right? And when I say year-to-date, of course, I'm talking about all of the totals up until this time, just for this year alone, right? Hardware and accessories are both down, and it is actually the Switch software that's offsetting declines in software posed by PlayStation and Xbox. And what we got to take into consideration there is that for the PlayStation side, they had a very phenomenal 2018. They had a record-breaking 2018, where Microsoft, not so much. It just proves that as far as total dollars and individual game sales, along with the hardware, it's just not performing well up until this point. Right, because they don't have a stellar 2018 to compare to,
right?
But that said, here goes some more notable performances. Madden 2020 is the best-selling game. It's also the second consecutive month that it's the best-selling game, because this year Madden came out early, and it's the seventh consecutive year that it's the best-selling game in August, and it's done so well, it's the third best-selling game year to date now, just by these 2 months alone. Here goes a surprising thing. Minecraft takes the number two spot in August as the second best-selling game. It's the 13th best-selling game year-to-date, so it's not charting top 10, but in August, it's charting as the second best-selling game. And Switch is the best-selling hardware this month. Now, in relation to Minecraft being the second best-selling game, again, we know Minecraft is a phenomenal game as far as sales are concerned and as far as saturation, and it's the best-selling game of all time. But I've pointed out time after time on this channel that even Minecraft for Xbox, even though it's a multi-plat and it's still doing well on various consoles, other consoles besides the Xbox ecosystem, that it hasn't charted all year, even in the top 10. So for it to hit second place in August really means that August is really an abysmal year, as far as sales are concerned, period. Wow. But let's go on, right? Other notable performances. It was not a great month for new games, as I've been alluding, right? Just a horrible, horrible month. Like, people really didn't burst out of the seams to purchase these new games. Astral Chain, my homeboy Emperor, Baron the Emperor, favorite game he feels is going to be the game of the year, debuted at number 10 in August. Wow. With that being said, Astral Chain, which is a Switch exclusive, represents four other games that make up the top 10 that are solely Nintendo games. So even though Astral Chain may have not debuted well, it still is amongst a lineup of games for the Switch that is just dominating the charts, along with Switch just dominating all year 2019. Age of Wonders, which is like a game not really being talked about, a strategy game, a new one, new IP, I believe it is. Or it might be a sequel, but it's one that's like kind of blipped on the radar within the last several weeks. It debuted at number 15. Okay. So, and then Racing Wheels, surprisingly, which also adds to the weirdness of August, Racing Wheels is the number one accessory for some reason in August, and it jumped 60% with a particular, I think it was a Logitech racing wheel for Nintendo, for Xbox, leading the pack. All right, so let's go over some more preliminary numbers here. Top 20 games on all platforms. I'm just gonna go over the top five, which some more information as far as the top 20 games, Spider-Man is still at number 11, okay. Rainbow Six Siege is at number 9. And then there are three Ubisoft games up here, and that's most of any third party, right? And once again, no AAA games from Xbox making the list. I read this wrong. This is in regards to the top 20 games so far this year, right? The top 20 games for August altogether. Those are some notable numbers. Again, Spider-Man is at number 11, which Spider-Man is just killing it. Rainbow Six Siege is number 9. There's three Ubisoft games up there again, most of any third party. And once again, no AAA games from Xbox. To be fair to Xbox, we're going to see how Gear changes that. We'll see how Gear changes that next month when those numbers are released. Okay, top games year to date for 2019 are Mortal Kombat 11, Kingdom Hearts 3, Madden, Division 2, baby, still running strong. Anthem, which again is surprising with all the doom and gloom Polygon publication did on the game. It's in EA access, so it's doing horrible. It's still the number 5 game this year. Smash Brothers is 6. 7 is Resident Evil 2, then followed up by GTA 5, Red Dead Redemption 2, and then Days Gone rounds up top 10 games. In a rolling 12-month calendar, meaning from August of 2018 to August of 2019, Red Dead Redemption 2 is still the number one game within that time frame. Call of Duty Black Ops 3 is 2, followed by NBA 2K19, then Smash Brothers. Spider-Man is after that. Spider-Man's killing it. Assassin's Creed Odyssey, yes, Ubisoft. You know I'm a Ubisoft stan now. Mortal Kombat 11, FIFA 19, Madden 19, and rounding out top 10, surprisingly. Again, this is Battlefield 5, y'all. All the heat that it's getting. Top 3 for each of the major platforms. For first, Xbox is Madden 20. Next is GTA 5. Minecraft is number 3. And number 4 is Rainbow Six Siege. For PlayStation 4, we have their top 3 at Madden 20, Minecraft, then GTA 5. And then lastly, the top 3 for the Switch is Fire Emblem, Smash Brothers, and Mario Maker 2. I did a top 4 for Xbox, if you didn't catch that effery there. I did it because it's an Ubisoft game. I just wanted people to know that Ubisoft is still in it this year. It didn't reach top 3, but Rainbow Six Siege, the game that everybody was crapping on at first, is still within the top 4. Thank you very much. With that being said, here's my prescription. It's not a good month at all for new games, including Control. And I'm going to put a lot of blame on, and I'm going to talk about this further maybe in a later video. I'm going to put a lot of blame on the fact that Control was sold exclusively on the Epic Game Store. We've seen time after time this year that when games don't sell well on console, they do very well on PC. We've seen that with The Division 2, you know, we've seen it in a number of instances where games may have not reached expectations on consoles, but the slack was picked up on PC. Being that Control was limited to the Epic Game Store, a very lauded and very disliked platform on PC, and that's a whole nother video. I think it hurt sales. It hurt sales, definitely. So something for Remedy to think about. I know they got that bag, but again, what is the long-term effects of you guys not releasing simultaneously on Steam, GOG, and all the other platforms? Not about you just being available on Steam, but you just supporting the openness of PC. PC people, I'm telling you, it's a different animal. PC people do not like the closed environment approach, okay? If you don't make the product, they don't want you closing it off to the rest of the masses, you know, as far as choice is concerned. But again, that's a whole nother thing. Nintendo also is destroying the competition this year. 2019 is the year of the Switch. No doubt about it. I think they've pretty much done a clean sweep. I think PlayStation may have won one NPD this year, but besides that, I think it's been a clean sweep for Switch. So phenomenal job by them. Spider-Man continues, though, to reign supreme as far as exclusives are concerned, in many fronts, as far as AAA banger exclusives are concerned. You know what I'm saying? You know, when you talk about your God of Wars or your Spider-Mans or your Halos or your Gears, Spider-Man is on top of that list. Not to take anything away from the Nintendo games, but the Nintendo games really aren't the AAA exclusives that we're talking about here. They're very good games, you know, the Zelda games and such, but again, I'm talking about the top-notch fidelity, those type of games. Spider-Man is the king so far, you know what I'm saying, in 2019 and a little bit beyond. And also, lastly, we can see that third-party publisher success for Xbox is due to Minecraft. Minecraft is breaking in a lot of money for Xbox, but now let's see if they'll be able to subsidize better games for the consumers of its own ecosystem with all that extra money. All right, that was a lot to cover and to give my take on. I hope y'all enjoyed it. That is it from your boy MM2K. Let me know what you think about all this, about new games getting the snub this month, and just the overall poor performance and racing wheels, you know, top and accessories. Let me know what you think about all that in the comment section below. Like I say, who cares what I think? But if you did like what I have to say, you can follow me per the links below. Also, I do a show with your peoples, Dirt Griggity, Snow Bunny, Needles, called Scrampunks. Check us out. Hashtag Scrampunks on the web for more information on that. Check me out with my brethren, the Broadband Bullies. We're out here doing a damn thing. Check out the Discord link. Check out the link to the Patreon. Check out the link to the gear, because it's fly. And last but not least, check your boy out on the Hard Knock Digital Culture. You can check it out either at hndc.live when I'm live, or you can go to twitch.tv/MightyMost2000. And with that said, you all have a wonderful, wonderful gaming day. Peace.